Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to demonstrate and describe about the Wimshurst machine. The Wimshurst machine is a basically electrostatic generator which generates high voltage and develops it. And it is invented by a British inventor which is named as James Wimshurst. So this machine is particularly developed to use the electrostatics and in the physics researches and also in the late 1880s to 1883s, so also used in X-ray tubes generally for generating the electrostatic charges. And nowadays this machine is generally used in physics researches, science museums, and to describing the principles to the students of electrostatics. So now we are going to describe the different parts of this machine, and then we operate this machine manually and see how it works. This is a basic representation of Wimshurst machine here, and in this the basic construction is consisting two insulating discs. These discs are rotated in a counter direction, so both the direction of front disc and rear disc are opposite to each other. Similarly, there are metal sectors on this disc in the even space, and on both the type of disc there are different metal sectors which generates the charges, because the metal sectors have consist electrons in a negative, and these are the neutralizing bars. So these bars have a brush on the both ends, of which brush are connected with the metal sectors. So these are touching the metal sectors, and similar neutralizing bar is also situated on the back side of the rear panel, and the rear disc and the rear bar is in the 90 degrees angle from the front bar. So the front bar, the neutralizing front bar, is in this direction, so the back side of bar is in this direction. The same bar is also provided on the back panel. Now these are the collecting combs in which the brushes are connected from both the sides, and this is also a collecting combs, and the electrodes with the metal spares on the front end, on the top of them, are provided to store the charges. Similarly, we have also introducing leaden jars. In these leaden jars, as we connect these handles to on both the electrodes, so the charges storage capacity will be increased when we connect the leaden jars with the electrodes. So this is all about this machine, and when we rotate this machine, the pulleys will rotate the disc in opposite direction and increasing the charges. So while we are working with this machine without the charges, without the leaden jars, so the charge storage will be slightly lower, and when we work with the leaden jars connected with the electrodes, so the charges will be stored in larger amount. So we'll now start explaining the working of this Wimshurst machine. So suppose the rear plate will start rotating with the negative charge provided on the after the neutralizing brush or the neutralizing bar. So this negative charge, as aligned with the positive charge here from the front brush, this will induce the positive charge in the front sectors of the metal. So this positive charge will now move towards the collecting comb, and this collecting comb stores the positive charge here. And similarly, as the positive charge induced here on the top side of this metallic sector, so the negative charge will be developed and induced on this end of this neutralizing bar. So as the negative charge developed, this negative charge will turns to the, as the machine, the front plate rotated here in this direction, so the negative charge will be collected with this comb from the front disc. Similar actions will also happen when this positive charge, induced positive charge, reaches in the line with the 90 degree aligned back neutralizing rod. So this neutralizing rod will induce the negative charge on the back side of the rear panel. So at this negative charge will induce. So this negative charge will again travel to the positive section here. After the neutralizing comb or the collecting comb stores the positive negative charge, and this connecting comb stores the positive charge according to the direction. So this is how the charges continuously stored, generate and neutralized with this neutralizing bar, and then again collected with the collecting comb. So as the machine moves continuously again and again, the disc moves again and again, the charges will start stored at these electrodes. So when the electrodes and the charge amount is increased through the air gap flux density, so the dielectric constant will cross and the breakover will occur in a spark form in both of the electrodes provided on the spherical metallic arms. So when the Leyden jars are connected, the charge storation will increase. So this will increase the more negative charge and this will increase the more positive charge. So this is how the machine works, and the charge continuously increased. And when the charge increased, and it will dissipate when the amount of the charges crosses the air gap density or the dielectric constant of the air. So as we rotate this machine, this will started storing the charge, and after the charge increased, this will dissipate the charge in an arc form or in a spark. Here you can see this is how the sparks generated. So this is working of Wimshurst machine. So you can try to see closely, the sparks are very lower in amount as the charges stored are lower. So this is the continuous sparking and continuous charge generation you can observe. And now we will short the both metallic spheres and remove the short circuit from both the terminals of Leyden jars. Like this. Now we will again start running the machine. The main advantage of this Wimshurst machine is that it is a self-starting machine. So there is no another and external electrical parts are provided to generate the electrons or the charges in the electrostatics, and this works in basic induction purpose. So this is the electrostatic induction working machine. There is no friction, and basically electrostatic charges are generated in other machines by the friction of the metallic objects. But in this type of machine, this generally works on the induction process. Now we will connect the Leyden jars with the handles. So the charge will be increased as the Leyden jar stores some of the amount of the charge. Now I am increasing the distance of both the metallic spheres, and now I am starting the machine. Here you can see the spark and the charge stores are now increased. As I increase the speed of rotating, the charge dissipation are also increased in the higher amount. The charge is slightly increased and stores in the Leyden jar right now, and as I close the both metallic spheres, the charge dissipates and discharges the Leyden jars. Now I have closed the distance of both the metallic spheres, and you will observe the charge is passing through the air gap flux. Now to see the bigger spark, you have to increase the distance, and now as the charge will store more, the spark will be more. Now for continuous dissipation, we will remove this short point from both the terminals, and now charges will be continuously dissipate. At this condition, we have to decrease the distance of both the metallic spheres. For appropriate distance, you will get this continuous spark. Now I will starting machine. Here you can see the sparks are continuously dissipating. After reaching the speed and proper charge dissipation, you will get the proper charge dissipation. So this is the distance, should be slightly lower, and again start the machine. So we have to first dissipate the charge properly and then increase the distance to generate the electrostatic charge like this. So this is the continuous sparks you can see over here. So this is generating the charges continuously. So these charges can be used in the physics researches and other electronic equipments for the electrostatic charges machine, in which the researchers and experiments are required. So this is about a basic demonstration of Wimshire's machine. And while working with this machine, make sure do not touch the any conducting part while as the Leyden jars and any other components have stored the charges, so you get the electrostatic shock. So this is not much as dangerous, but shocks should be need proper with the proper protections. So this is all about this practical description of this Wimshire's machine. And this machine is generally used nowadays in a practical purpose, and to give the physics researches and to show the how electrostatics works in the charge dissipation. So thank you for today.